You! You're back! We all thought... You know... Look, Elder Lyons and the others are assembled in the lab. There's talk of assaulting the Purifier. You'd better get down there right away.
Anything but the target.
You're back. Then you've reached a new level of understanding. Combat does not take place in the brain. It is passion, instinct, and the will to survive.
All I'm saying is, the longer we sit here, the more time they have to shore up their defenses. We should hit them sooner rather than later.
We barely have the manpower to keep the citadel fortified. We've been over this before, Sarah.
So we just wait until they decide we're next on the list? If the Pride goes in now, we might have a chance.
And if you fail, then what? The risk is not worth the reward.
I agree. Without the Gek, the Purifier is useless to the Enclave anyway. They may give up before long.
I don't like it.
You don't have to like it, Sarah. You just have to follow orders.
Yes, Father.
So, you're back. We had feared both you and the Gek were lost. Were you successful? Excellent. With that, we hold the key to keeping the Enclave from controlling the Purifier. What do you mean? Explain yourself. Then we must go at once. If you have any other information, tell me now before we mobilize. Any help you can give might save lives. I see. Where is this virus now? Thank you. I'll see to it that it's disposed of properly once the scribes have had time to analyze it. Perhaps we have underestimated the Enclave. Sarah may be right. An attack may be necessary now.
If the Enclave has the Gek, there's nothing stopping them from starting the Purifier. They'll figure out the code eventually.
I'm afraid you're right. We need to act now while we can.
Send the Pride in. We can do it. We can win this.
All right, Sarah. The Pride goes in. But I want them to have some extra firepower. Rothschild, is it ready?
What? No, I mean, Lee and I have solved the power problems, but we've only barely finished diagnostic tests.
So?
It's not ready for field tests, let alone live fire situations. The weapons haven't been calibrated, the navigation detection system is offline.
Rothschild, enough. Can you make it work?
Honestly, I don't know. I think we can scrape by, and I suppose if we can't, it won't matter in the long run anyway.
Then it's decided. Sarah, you take the Pride and use the robot as support. Take our friend here and secure that purifier.
Yes, sir. Before we get started, I wanted to let you know that my father and I have been talking. The Pride and I have decided that after all you've survived, you've done enough to be an honorary member of Lion's Pride. So congratulations. Membership comes with some privileges, including our power armor. You want the full suit or the recon armor? Sure thing. Hopefully, it'll give you a bit of an extra edge. Okay. So do you think you can hold it together for this? Me too. If you need a minute to collect yourself, now's the time to do it. Hurry it up! Every minute you take is one more that we can't afford to spend.
You You have something to say? Yes, by all means, let's. Yes, by all means, let's.
I'm sure you'll understand that there's far too much to be done right now. I have no time for chatting.
Are you ready now? We can't afford to keep standing around like this. Okay, don't be nervous. You'll have the whole pride backing you up, not to mention this giant tin can. Just stay safe until we reach the purifier. You're no good to us if you're dead. And don't let that thing step on you. Okay, we're going to go over it one more time. The pride is on me. The goal is Project Purity, but we can't get into the facility with those energy fields up. Rothschild and Lee say this robot should be able to take down the energy fields. So we're on fire support. We stay close to the thing, keep it clear, and get it to where it needs to go. Once the fields are down, we head straight for the facility. We'll use the robot to keep them occupied while we get inside and secure the control room. We need to move quickly before we lose the chance to surprise them. Get whatever supplies you don't already have, and we'll meet in the Bailey. When we're done with this, everyone can have a nice cold glass of water on me. Let's move. All right, Rothschild, fire it up. Pride, move out!
Thank you. You again. I can't say I'm surprised. You and your ilk seem hell-bent on destroying everything our government has worked to achieve. There's nothing to stop me from killing you this time. Let's end this. I beg to differ. The Enclave is at the height of its power. Once this facility is operational, the masses will flock to the Enclave for fresh water, protection, and a plan for the future. I am sworn to protect the presidency. The chain of command must be upheld. I wouldn't expect you to understand. And your point? I see. And what of the chain of command? When the Enclave fell on the West Coast, Eden was next in line for leadership. Yes, you're right. I had not considered it from that viewpoint. But then, where does that leave me? Such arrogance. If that's your wish, so be it. Take some small comfort in knowing you'll have little time to regret the decision.
Well, that takes care of that. By now, the Pride should be mopping up whatever opposition is left outside. Let's get this room secured.
Could explode. To release the pressure, you're going to have to turn the purifier on. Do you understand me? It has to be turned on now. If I'm reading this right, I'm afraid there are lethal levels of radiation inside the chamber. I'm sorry. I wish there were some other way, but there's just no time. It has to be done now, or the damage will be catastrophic.
Well, so much for celebrating. One of us is going to have to go in there and turn the damn thing on. And whoever does it isn't coming back out. Not exactly how I imagined going out, you know? So, what should we do? Draw straws? You're going to have to be quick about it. If the radiation is bad enough, you won't have much time. I won't forget what you've done here. No one will. Thank you.
Hold on, Jonas. I need to record this first. I don't really know how to tell you this. I hope you'll understand, but I know you might be angry. I thought about it for a long time, but in the end, I decided it was best for you not to know. So many things could have gone wrong, and there's really no telling how the Overseer will react when he finds out. It's best if he can blame everything on me. Obviously, you already know that I'm gone. Was something I needed to do. You're an adult now. You're ready to be on your own. Maybe someday things will change and we can see each other again. I can't tell you why I left or where I'm going. I don't want you to follow me. God knows life in the vault isn't perfect, but at least you'll be safe. Just knowing that will be enough to keep me going.
Don't mean to rush you, Doc, but I'd feel better if we got this over with.
Okay, go ahead. Goodbye. I love you.
And so it was that the lone wanderer ventured forth from Vault 101, intent on discovering the fate of a father who had once sacrificed the future of humanity for that of his only child. The Capital Wasteland proved a cruel, inhospitable place, but the lone wanderer refused to surrender to the vices that had claimed so many others. The values passed on from father to child: selflessness, compassion, honor, guided this noble soul through countless trials and triumphs. But it was not until the end of this long road that the lone wanderer learned the true meaning of that greatest of virtues: sacrifice. Stepping into the irradiated control chamber of Project Purity, the child followed the example of the father, sacrificing life itself for the greater good of mankind. Thankfully, when selected by the sinister president to be his instrument of annihilation, the wanderer refused. Humanity, with all its flaws, was deemed worthy of preservation. The waters of life flowed at last, free and pure for any and all. The Capital Wasteland, at long last, was saved. So ends the story of the lone wanderer, who stepped through the great door of Vault 101 and into the annals of legend. But the tale of humanity will never come to a close, for the struggle of survival is a war without end. And war never changes.